Although the debris might be picked up off the curb for many, residents are still trying to pick up the pieces of what Hurricane Ian left behind.
I was shocked to learn that 66 days after landfall, FEMA hasn't placed a single trailer, and they only have 11 trailers in processing to help the more than 12,000 residents who've applied for housing.
Lee County Chairman Brian Hammond says he's disappointed to hear this from FEMA at their workshop Tuesday, when he knows many residents are hoping for FEMA trailer approvals to be placed outside their homes while they rebuild.
But instead, FEMA has said, we're not going to put FEMA trailers in a flood zone. We're not going to help flood victims because they live in a flood zone.
FEMA tells me they can't put trailers here, which is Lockmore Waterway Estates, because it's on the river along a floodplain.
You had a lot of people in this county that died from this storm. We will not be responsible as the federal government for putting people in a location where they are likely to have potential future risk.
FEMA rules don't allow for their trailers to be put in flood zones, but 33% of Lee County is in a floodplain.
Most of Fort Myers Beach is in a floodplain.
That's why Hammond wants to find a solution.
I've called our congressman, actually, right after the meeting. I'm going to continue to call as many federal officials as I can. I even tweeted President Biden immediately after the meeting to let him know what the status is.
Michael Wade with FEMA tells me their hands are tied by the state and federal government.
So it's entirely up to the state and the local authorities to do what they think is necessary to help their citizens.
Although Hammond says the board would consider removing any ordinances standing in FEMA's way.
Whatever they do can not only affect the county, particularly when it comes to floodplain management, it can actually affect the people that can currently afford flood insurance.
Although what Lee County and FEMA both agree to is finding out-of-the-box creative ways to aid hurricane survivors.
If those are not available, then our last resort is to build a community site somewhere in the county and then move approved applicants into that community site.
So some of our viewers might be thinking, hey, it's dry season now. Why can't FEMA just put the trailer there? But we have to remember, people might be in those trailers for a while, right?
Absolutely. So these trailers are designed for people to live in them for up to 18 months. So obviously that would take us right through next hurricane season, and that's why FEMA says they don't want to do it.
And hopefully we don't have another Hurricane Ian next season, but I guess you got to be prepared. Hopefully we can find some sort of compromise. Alexia, thank you.